If you're like me, you may like your drinking water to be colder than what you could normally get direct from your water ionizer. Or you may want to bring water from your ionizer to work with you, or to the park, or to a friend's house, or on that long road trip to your mother-in-law's house. No matter where you want to go with it, you may be asking the question, what's the best type of container to store alkaline ionized water made from a water ionizer? Hey guys, I'm Dean Snyder from Snyder Health. Welcome to this week's episode of Water Ionizer Wednesday. In this short video, I'll show you the best way to store your alkaline water and what type of container you should store it in. The first thing I want to do is talk about the three major benefits of alkaline ionized water, and that's alkalinity, ORP, and molecular hydrogen. And then I'll show you the best type of container you can use to maintain all three of those health factors for the longest period of time. The first benefit of your water ionizer I want to talk about is the high pH of the drinking water. Believe it or not, the alkalinity of water is the least important health factor of those three when it comes to drinking water. ORP and molecular hydrogen levels have a much greater impact on your health than the pH of the water. Although when we're talking about water from a water ionizer, ORP and pH go hand in hand. The one major factor that can affect the pH of water is temperature. Studies show us that as the temperature goes up inside of a container of water, the pH will begin to drop. So for example, water with a pH of 7.5 at 0 degrees Celsius will gradually drop to a pH of 6.1 when the temperature rises to 100 degrees. So since a higher temperature can affect the pH of our drinking water, that tells us that if we're going to store water from our water ionizer, we want to keep that water as cold as possible to retain the pH of the water. Now, the alkalinity may stay relatively the same, meaning the mineral content won't change, but the pH value will begin to go down. So that just tells us that the best way to store alkaline water is in the refrigerator, or if you're traveling, in some sort of cooler. And those same studies show that the pH of the water will remain fairly stable for long periods of time. So other than your water container sitting in a hot car, you don't really have to worry about the pH of water changing very much, especially in the relatively short amount of time before you actually drink it, even if it's a week later. Keep in mind that light can also affect the pH of water, as a clear bottle being exposed to light, especially ultraviolet light, will cause the temperature to go up inside the container. The second factor is the ORP level of the water, or oxidation reduction potential. In a previous video, I talked about ORP in detail, so if you haven't seen it yet, I'll post a link in the description area below so you can go check it out. Drinking water from your water ionizer is going to have a relatively low negative ORP level, meaning it's going to contain a lot of energy. The water's ORP level, just like the pH level, will be negatively affected by both temperature and light, but also, more importantly, will be dramatically affected by the thickness of the walls of the container that you're using. Because ORP is a measurement of energy, the thinner the walls of the container, the quicker the negative ORP will be lost as it normalizes to its surrounding atmosphere. So for example, a regular 1 gallon plastic milk jug is made from very thin plastic and therefore is a terrible container when it comes to ORP levels. Something like a thick glass container would be much more suitable, as the thickness of the walls of the container will slow down the loss of that negative ORP level. Also, you want to use a material with the least amount of conductivity. Therefore, something like a single-walled stainless steel bottle is not a great idea, because the conductivity of the metal will allow a very quick transfer of energy from inside the bottle to the outside. So the goal to retain ORP levels is to reduce the contact distance that the water has to the outside air and to use a material with the least amount of conductivity. In any type of plastic or glass bottle, you can expect the ORP to normalize relatively quickly, maybe something like a day or so. Nowhere near the length of time you can retain the pH level of the water, as I talked about before. The last and most important factor is molecular hydrogen. If you happen to own a water ionizer that can create an abundance of molecular hydrogen, like my Vesta H2 ionizer that you see here, then the most important factor of a drinking water container would be its ability to be completely sealed and leak-proof. Because molecular hydrogen is a gas, it will quickly dissipate from the water if the container is not completely sealable. Most plastic bottles will not seal correctly and will allow the molecular hydrogen to gas out of the container, and you'll quickly lose that major health benefit. It's no different than that big bottle of soda you have in the fridge. You'll notice that no matter how tight you put the cap back on the bottle, the soda will eventually go flat, because plastic bottles are not meant to be completely airtight. So the goal of retaining the molecular hydrogen in the drinking water is to use a container that is completely leak-proof, which will keep the molecular hydrogen in the drinking water. Also, here's a tip. Make sure that whatever container you're using, that you fill the container up with as much water as possible right up to the lip, so that there's the least amount of air in the bottle. If you leave a space of air towards the top of the bottle, then the molecular hydrogen will gas out into that space. So fill your container to the tippy top before you put the lid back on. So now, taking all of those three factors into consideration, which container should you be using to store your alkaline ionized water? As I mentioned, plastic is terrible for long-term storage. Not only won't it seal properly, but the walls of most plastic containers are relatively thin. And most plastic bottles are translucent, meaning they allow light to pass through and potentially alter the pH of the water very quickly. So if you're going to use a plastic bottle, I would suggest only using it for about an hour or so. For example, when I go to the gym, I use a BPA-free plastic sports bottle because I like being able to squeeze the bottle. But the water in that bottle is gone in less than an hour because I drink the whole bottle while I'm working out. The next type of container is a glass bottle. Glass bottles have a relatively low conductivity and therefore will maintain the negative RP levels much longer than plastic. Also, glass bottles can be purchased with a UV protection, like an amber or blue bottle, which will prevent the ultraviolet light from entering the bottle. That'll help stabilize the pH for much longer compared to a clear bottle. Also, glass bottles can have a sealable lid, which will be much more leak-proof than a plastic bottle and will be able to help maintain the molecular hydrogen level in that water for much longer. A perfect example of that type of bottle is the one you see right here. This is a 1 liter cobalt blue UV protected bottle with a swing top ceramic lid. It also has a rubber seal, which makes this bottle almost completely airtight. This would be the best example of a glass bottle that you would want to use if you decide to go with a glass drinking bottle. I'll post a link in the description area below where you can get a bottle just like this one. And lastly, the absolute best bottle that you can use to store alkaline ionized water is a double-walled, vacuum-sealed, leak-proof stainless steel bottle. With this type of bottle, all three health aspects of your alkaline ionized water will remain intact for the longest possible period of time. First, it's temperature-proof, meaning that because of the vacuum space between the two walls, there is no transfer of heat. Therefore, the cold water inside the bottle will remain cold for a long period of time, and any outside hot air won't affect the temperature of the drinking water inside. That'll help to keep the pH of your water stable at whatever it was when you put it in the bottle. The second thing is, due to the same vacuum between the double wall, there is no conductivity. That means that the ORP level of your water will remain stable for a long time without much change to the electron load of the water. And the fact that these types of bottles are leak-proof means that all of the molecular hydrogen will stay in the water where it's supposed to be. The same rule applies, as I mentioned before. Just make sure to fill up the bottle to the very top to reduce any air gap inside the bottle. With this type of bottle, you'll be able to keep the pH, ORP, and molecular hydrogen fairly stable for more than a week, making it a perfect container for long trips or just to store in the refrigerator for a week if you have a bunch of them. Again, I'll post a link in the description area below to where you can pick up one of these bottles that comes in different designs and bottle sizes. But listen, if I'm going to be honest here, the absolute very best way to get the maximum benefit from your water ionizer is to drink the water directly from the machine as you're making it. But since most of us have a job to go to or places we have to be, then using a stainless steel double-walled vacuum-sealed leak-proof airtight bottle is the very best way to take your water with you and still maintain the health benefits of the water. Now, if you'd like to take a look at a brand new Vesta H2 water ionizer like the one that I have, take a look in the description area below for a link that will save you $450 off the retail price. Let me know in the comment section below what type of bottle you use when you leave the house. Also, if you haven't done it yet, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you can be alerted each week when I release a new video in the series. You can subscribe to the channel by clicking on this big round button right here, and you can watch other videos in the Water Ionizer Wednesday video series by clicking on either one of those right over there. Until next week, stay safe during this ridiculous apocalypse. Hopefully you managed to get some toilet paper like I did the other day.